1-0, just an update on this pump I bought the other day, I purchased from Amazon. It's a 10,000 litre pond pump. I've got it all fixed up, as I said yesterday, on that house brick. I just put a styrene to put on. Ignore the string, I'll just put it on temporary to give it a try in the pond so I can retrieve it more easily. I'll sort that out in a minute. But my setup is the moment that pump there is going to sit in the bottom of my pump down there, which is then going to connect up to that hose there, which is, bear with me, feeding or running under the so-called patio area, which I'm going to be doing this year, but I don't want to go into that because all the building mergers are shut, so it's going to be a long project. At the back of the wall there, at the back of my border, to my homemade K1 filter. That's got a 2-inch outlet back to the pond with I think it's about 8mm holes drilled in it all round, hence the onion sleeve. This is like a mesh stop the K1 media going back to the pond. Overflow and a air feed, which has got, I think it's a 4-inch pond air stone at the bottom of that. So just make that on quickly. At the moment it's drained down because obviously I'm changing the pumps over. Normally it sits round about there. And once it starts rising up, that tells me that that mess is getting clogged up, so hence needs cleaning. And go back to the pond. Well, I've got the moment, what I've been running on, that's the hose lock 6,000 litre per minute pond pump, which was sitting in the bottom there. I did have two, that's 6,000 that's in the bottom there, which was feeding that K1 media. It's okay, but hence it does need a bit sank more stronger. And in that corner there, I did have another hose lock, 4,500 litre per minute pump, which run back of the fence. I was feeding this Oasis. This is a clear pond 25. When I first started off, I had goldfish and a couple of koi. Obviously over the years, koi get bigger, just more muck, so this was struggling. Hence why I made the K1 filter off the old water butt. I have to thank Terry Wright for that, well known as Wrighty, one of his followers, gave me the idea, which does help out a lot. It does pick up all the big solids at the bottom. This, at the time when it was running on that 4,500 litre, was basically using like for the fine stuff, which does me okay. But before that, it's just run on this, struggling. I was having to clean it out every other day. And wasn't doing my back much good. So, hence, should just get Murray going by. Hence why I need some upgrades and try to sort it out. Above that, I've got my Evo Aqua Ultraviolet. That's my second one. What I would say is be very careful when you change the UV bulb. I wasn't. I broke the, the quartz sleeve and inside. Didn't know, rigged it all back up, it's working okay for a couple of days and then it's packed up. Hence when I took it apart, I had a close look, I see the cracked quartz sleeve. Took that back, I tried to repair it myself, but it was okay, but it just wasn't lighting up. So I took it back to where I bought it from, which is Swallows Aquatics at Gravesend. I had a tinker around with it, still no joy. When I looked into it, it still had its year guarantee. So they exchange it. So big thanks for Swallow Aquatics at Gravesend for helping me out on that. I didn't know that, and much appreciated. So that's the replacement. So just a quick test, that's up and running okay. But as for this area itself, this is like temporary I need to make some sort of a cupboard or case for this, and that will eventually be going. And I don't want to get in place of that. I'm not sure. I'm an easy pod, or I am looking into an Eric filter at the moment. I don't know, but I need to get this cupboard sorted out first. And in this box here, I don't know if it is, but that's my air stone, or air pump, sorry, which has got two air stones in there. I did have seven, but I think it's a bit over the top, so I've taken five out. I just have two. And that seems to be doing okay. So what I'll do is, I'll finish this now. I'm going to chuck that new pump in. I'm going to give it a run and try and fathom out those controls. And I will keep updated on that. We'll see, or I'll show you the outcome of it, sorry. Okay then guys, thanks a lot. Catch you later.